The pandemic has couples rethinking what's important in life, and for many, that means having a baby. One infertility specialist told me his patient load has quadrupled. Now, artificial intelligence is dramatically increasing a person's chances of getting pregnant. It is a story all new at 9. Infertility treatments have come a long way since the first IVF in Missouri 35 years ago at Barnes Jewish Hospital and Washington University School of Medicine. The chances of IVF working back then was 20%. Now it's more than 60%.
Today, if you're under 35, you have at least a 50% chance of success, in some situations up to a 70%, 80% chance of success.
Couples like Andrea and Alan Nays of Imperial couldn't get pregnant on their own.
It's definitely hard hearing from, whether it's friends or family or just random people, that, you know, they weren't even trying to get pregnant and they got pregnant. You know, why can't it be that easy for us?
The Nayses had fertility help with their first child. Now, 3 years later, they wanted to try again, this time through in vitro fertilization at the Fertility and Reproductive Medicine Center at WashU.
Our insurance didn't cover it, so everything that we did was out of pocket.
The cost of IVF is now around $12,000. WashU doctors are using something called an AI machine. After the eggs are retrieved and combined with the sperm, the AI machine selects which embryos have the best chances of survival.
This tool helps us better refine which of those patients on day three should be grown out to day five, so that we can increase the chances, and this is key, Mandy, so that we can increase the chances of success with one single embryo. Because if we transfer one embryo on day five, we're going to increase the chances of taking home one healthy baby.
Dr. Keenan Obertag says it cuts down on multiple pregnancies. It worked for the Nayses.
We are 22 weeks as of this past Tuesday, and we're having a boy this time.
Technology and the pandemic are reasons more people are turning to IVF.
We're seeing more people maybe make decisions because they now have time and the access to do it.
Infertility affects one in five couples who are trying to conceive.